Amen, amen. Thank God for that mighty word. I thank God for the opportunity to be here. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, I thank you for this moment, Father. Use me, Father. Let your will be done, Father. And in conclusion, Father, I pray that you will be saved. Well done, thy good and faithful servant.
Amen.
Thank God for this opportunity. I will be coming from the book of Luke, chapter 23, verse 46. It is the seventh word, and the Bible gives us this understanding. And Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit.
Yes.
And having said this, he gave up the ghost.
Oh, yes.
Amen, amen, amen. I'd like to speak for just a brief moment on the subject, into thy hands moment. Into thy hands moment.
Mm-hmm.
When I was looking at the text and seeing everything that Jesus had gone through, I asked Jesus, I said, Lord, could you show me how to make it out of the enemy's hand alive?
Mm-hmm.
He said, sit down and I'll tell you how to do it.
All right.
He said, first you need to understand that no matter what your title is and how connected you are to the Father, you are going to have good days and bad days.
All right.
All right.
Yeah.
Then he said, you need to understand that you cannot avoid the enemy.
Yeah. That's right. That's right.
He said, I tried it in Gethsemane. It didn't work for me.
That's right. That's right.
He said, if it's God's will, then his will be done.
Yeah.
He said, next you need to tell your friends.
Uh-huh.
There'll be no cutting off of ears today.
All right.
He said, you can't fight depression. You can't fight cancer.
Right.
You can't fight low self-esteem. You can't fight demonic spirits like folk fight with guns and knives in the streets. He said, this is going to have to be a good fight of faith.
All right.
And he said, when they come for you, he said, when they start pulling you away, he said, ask grace and mercy to come along for the ride. Because he said, sometimes when they get rough in the enemy's hands, he said, grace and mercy will whisper into your ear and remind you the fight is not yours. It belongs to the Lord. And then he said, with all that, you got to be humble. He said, you know I like a humble person.
That's right.
He said, you've got to be humble, but you've got to be bold in the Lord.
Yeah.
Yes. He said, look at my situation. Mm-hmm. So he said, I told Mary that is now your son.
Yeah. Jesus.
He said, I told one of the gentlemen, I'll see you in my daddy's house.
Yes.
He said, in the midst of being in the enemy's hands, he said, I was making plans for my future.
All right. Yeah.
God said, you got to be bold enough. When the enemy think he's taking you out, you make the plan for what's going on after this. You make the plan for what you're going to do. Because you know this too. It shall pass. Yes, it shall pass. Then he said, you've got to be bold. He said, sometimes even though you're in the enemy's hands, you got to remind them who you are. And whose you are. He said, you need to look at my situation.
Yeah.
He said, things got a little out of hand when I was on the cross. Got a little out of hand. Yesterday. He said, because I told them, you can beat me. But they went off track. He said, they didn't want to follow the script. He said, because they tried to break my legs.
Yeah.
And he said, you know they ain't break my legs.
All right.
He said, because right there, he said, I had to remind you just who I am.
Yeah.
He said, because the script said clearly, you can beat me, but you'll never break me.
Yeah.
You see, God looking for some people that will love to tell the enemy, even though I'm in your hands, you can beat me, but you'll never break me.
Right.
He said, that's how you make it out the enemy's hands.
Yeah.
Still alive.
All right.
He said, you got to have faith. grace and mercy.
Yes.
You got to be bold in the Lord.
All right.
Yes.
But he looked at me and said, you don't want to just make it out.
All right.
He said, you don't want to just come out, do you?
Yeah.
He said, I'm going to show you how to change your life.
Yes.
He said, because you don't want to come out and not be changed.
Yeah.
I said, yeah, Lord, because if I'm not changed, then I'm going to be going through that thing again and again and again.
Yes.
So I said, yeah, Lord. I said, I want to come out and I want to be changed.
Yes.
He said, well, in order for you to be changed, you got to have an into thy hands moment. He said, that's when you tell the Lord, I'm turning it over to you. That's when you say, that's when you say that you tired of messing with the enemy. That's when you say that you done fooling around. That's when you say you tired of being depressed. That's when you say you tired of being bamboozled. That's when you say you tired of being put down and talked about. That's when you tired of being beat down. He said, that when you have an into thy hands moment, that's when you tell God, God, take over. I done drove as long as I can. I done crashed up against stuff, done fell asleep at the wheel. Lord, I need somebody that's going to watch over me. He said, that's an into thy hands moment. When you say, Lord, take the lead. Oh, and I got bad news for you. I'm sorry. He said, all them folk that you praying for. He said, them children that you praying for. He said, them church members. Them church members, we got to pray for them too. He said, them church members that you praying for. Them co-workers that you praying for. You don't want to see at the water cooler them church, them workers that you work praying for. He said, all that praying don't mean anything.
All right.
He said, because they got to have their own into thy hands.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
He said, they got to have their own. He said, ain't nothing changing. And he said, listen, the enemy don't like it when you have an into thy hands moment.
Right.
The enemy don't like it when you turn it over to God. Because when you turn it over to God, all that stuff they've been doing against you, God gonna bring it to an end. He don't like it when you turn it over to God. I wonder if I got anybody that remember your moment. Oh, remember when you got to that moment that you said, God, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. Lord, I'm tired of going through. I'm tired of stressing. Is there anybody that remember the moment that you gave it to the Lord? I'm going to take my seat. But I'm going to testify just a little bit. I'm going to testify just a little bit because I remember when I had mine. When I had mine into thy hands moment.
Yeah.
I looked at my hands. My hands looked new. But when I had my into thy hands moment, I looked at my feet. My feet looked new. And let me tell you something. Since I had my into thy moment, places I used to go, I don't go anymore. Since I had my into thy hands moment, things I used to do, I don't do anymore. Since I had my into thy hands moment, friends don't treat me like they used to. Since I had my into thy hands moment, is there anybody that can give God praise? Is there anybody that will thank God? There's no moment in your life when you say, Lord, take over. I'm tired of trying to do myself. I'm trying to be my own. He said, I need somebody to take over the wheel. Tell your neighbor, ain't nothing changing in your life until you had an into thy hands moment. Until you said, Lord, into thy hands, I commit my life. I give it all up to you. I give it all up to you. Praise the Lord, somebody. Throw your moment. God told me it can happen in a hospital. It can happen in a courtroom. It can happen in a bar. It can happen in school. God said, thank him for this moment. But he's right there. When you ready to change, tell your neighbor. Get up there and tell those children, those wavering.
your children. Tell those people in the world if the world will change. You got to have it. You got to have it. It ain't gonna happen till you have it in the by hand moment. I pray that you bless you. Pray that you bless you. Pray that you bless you.